Hey guys, this is Andong. I am deep inside a forest in northwestern Russia. I'm on a little bit of a mission here. I'm trying to see what type of local food I can find that I can turn into a Russian flavors inspired taco and eventually do a taste test with my grandparents, who I believe have never ever had a taco in their entire life. So it's about time, I would say. And you probably have a lot of questions right now, so maybe we should start from the beginning. What's up, guys? I am back at the motherland. So yesterday I decided to take a super spontaneous trip.
Здрасте. Не мешаю никому?
Ну просто, чтобы вот это установить здесь, надо разрешение.
I literally entered the country like an hour ago. Turns out it's really not that difficult to get into trouble in Russia, I guess. By the way, this is actually a really beautiful monument to the siege of Leningrad, which is when the Nazis tried to take over the city during World War II. And they tried for 900 days, but they couldn't because they underestimated how badass people in the city are. Just saying. So I came to Russia because I wanted to hang out with my grandparents and ideally cook something delicious for them. But here's the catch. They're not actually in town. They are a few hundred kilometers away in deep Russia. In deep, deep Russia. And that's where we have to go to find them first. But also, I'm extremely hungry. So walk with me. I've made it. So I'm here at St. Petersburg's Lenin Square. Clearly nobody's in a rush here to erase that Soviet past. It's actually really nice here. It's a beautiful day. There's a fountain. The river is over there. I kind of feel like I should be here with Mr. Bald. Is anybody watching Bald and Bankrupt? Anyhow, I am starving. So good thing I just bought a whole bag of Russian food. I got it from this delicious place called Stolle. They specialize in these traditional Russian stuffed pies. They look absolutely gorgeous, so I am super pumped to finally try them and see if they are as tasty as they look. I got four different types. Let's taste the first one. Whoa! Oh my God, look at this. Oh, it smells so good! This must be the mushroom, cheese, and potato filling. Yes, yes. Very good. But we have a few more to try. Oh yeah. This one is called kuryatnik. Let's translate this as the chickenator. Holy shit. Everyone loves chicken, but this is great. I think this one also has a little bit of sour cream and rice. I'm getting thirsty, but that is not a problem. Look, we have mors. So this mors or morsik is basically just a Russian style juice made from berries. This one is made with klyukva, which I think is lingonberry, but I'm not 100% certain. Oh, this is heaven. It's tart, it's not too sweet, it has this like very slight bitter note, which I kind of like. Oh, hello. This is the green onion and egg filling. It's really, really fresh. Those spring onions, those leeks, are really intense and they complement the eggs so well. Last one, cabbage. A cabbage-filled pie, it sounds so plain, but it's really not. It's nice and buttery, which I think helps a lot. I think the chickenator was my favorite, closely followed by the cabbage one, but they were all really, really good. But now we have a train to Karelia to catch. Let's go. This trip was actually so last minute that I didn't get any regular seats anymore. All I got was a business class seat, resulting in me being the only passenger in this business class. This train arrives really, really late, which means I'm gonna see you tomorrow morning in Karelia. All right, good morning, everybody. I've officially made it to this place called Kiryavalahti Bay, which is the most northern point of Lake Ladoga, the biggest lake in all of Europe. I've been coming here quite a lot as a kid, almost every year, I believe, to visit my grandparents, who've been coming here almost every year as well.
Сколько раз вы уже здесь были?
50-й год.
Полвека.
This place right here is actually something like an old school Soviet holiday resort. But the history of this region called Karelia is actually pretty interesting. So the people of Karelia used to have their own pretty distinct culture. They were like cousins of the people of Finland. But during the last like 150 years, this place just kept going back and forth between Russia and Finland and the Soviet Union. And by now, it's just an autonomous region of Russia. But actually, there are hardly any native Karelians left. Almost everybody's family has moved here from the Soviet Union at some point in time. But somehow this place has still managed to maintain a little bit of a unique character. And it's like really well known for its beautiful nature, which unsurprisingly reminds people of Scandinavia. Anyway, let's enter the Karelian forest. I want to show you some of the beautiful nature, see if we can find anything to eat, and hopefully not get lost. This is how it looks. Would you dare going in? So I gathered a handful of mushrooms, but you know, nothing worth mentioning really. Except I found an enormous one, but normally when you find something that big, nature has gotten to it before you did. Also no blackberries. Normally this place is full of them, but you know what? The upshot is, I found a lake! This lake is really just breathtakingly beautiful, and there's no road leading here. Like, you have to walk through the woods to get here. Okay. I stand corrected. There are berries. Not blueberries as I expected, but cranberries. That's also good. I love them. Wild cranberry from the woods. Fruity, tart, a little bit bitter, you know, cranberries. I've been coming to this place almost all my life, since I was a really little kid, but mostly while I was in high school. And at that time, I really didn't cook that much. So I finally wanna cook something in this place. And for that, I really wanna like absorb the flavors and the atmosphere and create some kind of interesting dish. That's why I have mentioned mushrooms. That's why I have mentioned berries. But there is actually one more food item that I can absolutely not leave unmentioned when I talk about Karelian food, which is... So we're basically at the border between Russia and Finland right here. And Finland is also dubbed the land of a thousand lakes. And I would say that this definition clearly expands to Karelia as well. Those cars are nasty. And where there are lakes, there is fish. Therefore, fish is a huge staple food for the people of Karelia. There's this new eco-friendly fish farm nearby that doesn't only sell great fish, but they also have a restaurant that specializes specifically in Russian Karelian food. Now that sounds about perfect for us, I would say. The only downside is we gotta walk there for about an hour. So I'll see you there. Okay. So as I was walking, it started pouring. I'm still wet, which sucks. But you know what doesn't suck? I spotted this. And then I looked there and I spotted this. Do you see them? Whoa! Those look awesome. And right there, one more. Check out this guy. There it is. Finally, I'm so hungry.
Здравствуйте. Можно, пожалуйста, одни пельмени из форели и калитки.
Это кусочки?
Да.
Форели. А это горячего копчения.
Okay. This stuff is precisely what I need right now. It's cold, it's rainy, but this is comfort. So these are Russian dumplings, Russian pельмени, and what makes these pельмени special is that they fill them with fresh trout and smoked trout with a bit of sour cream. Just a cute little dumpling. Big bites, guys. Such a beautiful smoky flavor. Cute little fish ball inside. Oh man, that's so good. The dough is nice and chewy as well, and with sour cream and dill. Now I'm gonna try this. This is their homemade smoothie with local blueberries. Well, that is a good smoothie. Quite heavy on the apple, but I like it. I like apples. These, my friends, are a truly uniquely Karelian dish. They're like these little pastries made from rye flour, and they have all sorts of different fillings. Like these ones are, this is made with pieces of fresh trout, and this is made with minced smoked trout. They also make them with cheese, mushrooms, potatoes, almost anything that you can find in Karelia. Let's try the fresh trout first. I just really love the taste of rye, you know, that slightly nutty and roasty, toasty aroma of rye bread. It's great. Comes through so well. Now let's try the smoked trout. Wow. Okay, Russian people definitely know how to smoke fish. It's so good. Man. My mom actually has a really good recipe for kalitki. I'm gonna share this with my Patreon supporters this week. This is almost like a Karelian taco. Karelian taco. I have an idea. So I want to see if I can like come up with a Karelian taco. I don't really know what that is yet, but I have a couple of ideas. So the plan is that we're going to go into Sertavala, the next biggest town, and see if we can find some babushkas selling local produce. Welcome to Sertavala. This is what a small town in Russian Karelia looks like. Yeah, well, I wonder how many vloggers they have on the streets here. So I already bought some herbs, mushrooms and berries from a few babushkas and dedushkas at the side of the road. Looked really, really fresh. So my idea is starting to come together, but there are still quite a few things I have to do until this will become a reality. So to make a Karelian fish taco, we will need a Karelian fish. Oh, sorry about that. We will need a Karelian fish. Now, the premium way to do that is, of course, to catch the fish ourselves, which is indeed what I'm trying to achieve right now on this tiny, tiny boat. That looks safe. Yeah. So I generally do know how to do that, but you know, it's fishing. Who knows? So we might have to take another trip to the fishery tomorrow. Let's see about that. Shut the hell up. I really love fishing. It's extremely meditative, but probably extremely boring for you to watch. So yesterday night was a lot of fun. Very beautiful sunset, but I caught exactly zero. It's 6 a.m. now, and I'm gonna see if I'm more lucky this morning. So today I used a very different style of fishing, you know, very classic line hook and sinker setup. It's much easier to catch something like this, but it's also very likely that the fish is gonna be a lot smaller. Speaking of which, fresh fish from the lake right behind me. I know these are super small, but hey, this is not a supermarket. This is nature, you guys. You gotta take what nature provides. And I think it's gonna be delicious.
Tata, научи меня поджарить вкусную рыбку.
Прямо сейчас, ну, мы в дачных условиях попробуем почистить этот улов. Чистим рыбку, снимаем чешую. Она очень легко снимается, эта чешуя, потому что она поймана только что. Я ее тут промываю. Так. От хвоста к голове надо вспороть внутренности. Этот процесс называется потрошить рыбку. В головной части у нее жабры тоже лучше отрезать и удалить. Они дают горечь. Научилась у милого папочки. Папа был рыбак, по происхождению уральский рыбак. Много занимался рыбалкой, сам готовил себе снасти. Где моя соль? Вот моя соль. Немножечко посолить. Теперь мы приготовим обвалочку для рыбы. Мука. А на сковородке, на сковородочке масло растительное. Можно добавить для вкуса немножко и сливочного, тоже бы было интереснее немножко. Масло шипит. Мы берем рыбку, обваливаем ее в муке с двух сторон и на горячую сковородку. Главное, что она только что выловлена из озера. Свежевыловленная рыба – это совсем другой вкус. Да. Прекрасно. Мой папа так любил рыбу ловить, чистить даже и жарить, ну уж я не говорю о том, чтобы съесть, что он даже не давал эту работу ни жене, не мне, дочери. Лучшее блюдо из рыбы, которое я помню по его рассказам, это пирог с линем. Тесто выкладывается на противень, туда укладывается уже разделанная рыба, и второй слой теста накрывает эту рыбу сверху. Защипывается с краешков, и такой пирог с линем готовится в печи. Вот теперь можно переворачивать рыбку на другую сторону. Вот так. Аккуратно. У меня есть немножко лука. Я бы прибавила так, чтобы запах жареного лука тоже давал какой-то свой добавочный вкус. Свежепожаренная озерная рыбка готова. Пожалуйста.
All right, I believe I have all the ingredients I need now. So let me present you with my version of the Russian Karelian-inspired taco-ish thing. Did I mention I have extremely limited tools to work with? Let's see how this goes.
А что ты этим хотел сказать?
Карельский тако.
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 Вы когда-то ели тако?
Нет, я не ела.
О! Какая красивая, дивная.
Блин. Сметанки?
Сметанка?
Непростая, с укропом.
Это филе свежеподжаренной рыбки.
О!
Дедуня.
Да.
Не кушает рыбу.
Не кушает.
Поэтому ой, тебе.
Ой-ой-ой-ой-ой.
Вегетарианский пост.
Ой-ой-ой-ой-ой-ой. Все.
Брусничный соус.
Боже!
Да.
Я такого в жизни нет. Если я это съем, я, по-моему, уже могу считать, что моя жизнь
состоялась.
Состоялась. Вот ты знаешь, что такое симфония? Вот это симфония.
Это можно кушать.
Каким образом? Руками? Ну, может быть, второй блин сверху закрыть?
Да, надо как наш сделать. Крошек вот так вот вылезать.
Нет, нет, трубочку сделать, трубочку сделать. Или кулечек.
И вот, оп. Чуть-чуть надо повернуть. Чуть-чуть надо повернуть.
Скажи, пожалуйста, а рты в Мексике такие же?
О!
И все глядящие на тебя облизываются, а ты ешь. Вот твое преимущество.
Кистая, угу. Полупарочка.
А так?
Не вали дурака. Серьезное дело. Давай. Вкусно.
Я никогда не думал, что такое чудо может произойти в Кириевалахте. Обалдеть можно.
А можно я возьму с того стола салфеточку?
Но ты учти, что больше снимать нас нельзя, потому что я потерял всякий раз. Единственное, что мне не нравится, что когда нам так вкусно, люди должны только смотреть и глотать слюнки. Я поцелую пальчики, которые ели эту тако.
Подписывайтесь к каналу. My name is Anton.